This is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com with the update here in the backyard, getting the raised beds built. Rick and Karen have been working hard over the Memorial Day weekend to get the back post sunk, and now Rick's screwing on the sides of the raised bed in the back. And let's see, I came over after my trip to LA and I'm here to help them out, and they're going to continue with doing the raised beds, and what they're going to do is put on all the fronts. And so then we're going to leave a walkway and we're going to leave the ends open. And while they're doing that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to come over here. And at first they bought some chicken wire to line the bottom because they do have some gophers in this area. And then I highly advise that they, return the chicken wire and get this solid stuff. This is hardware cloth. It's a much more thicker gauge than the, chicken wire. And it's a... The spacing is a lot closer too. So the chicken wire, maybe a gopher would have to bite out like a little bit to get through. With this, they're gonna have to really work hard to get through. So, you know, not much more expensive, and just, you know, my whole idea is do it right the first time, and this is definitely do it right. So what we're gonna do is this conveniently comes in a 4 foot width, and check this out if Rick's measurements were on. All right, look at that. 4 feet exactly in between. What we're gonna have to do is we're gonna take these diagonal cutters and just cut around where the posts are going to be, and I'm going to go ahead and do that now. We're going to put this underneath the irrigation, then we're going to do the sheet mulch, and then I'm going to start wheelbarrowing in some compost, and they're probably going to be ready to plant tonight, hopefully. So let's see how it goes. So Rick and Karen are working on screwing in the front, and it's all coming together. Look how good that looks. And I'm also putting in all this fabric cloth now. I got it laid up on top, and we're going to cut out where the posts go and get this all laid down. All right, so I'm making the final cuts here of the hardware cloth, which is the gopher barrier, so the gophers can't burrow up into the bed to eat all the roots of the vegetable plants and everything like that. And we trimmed it to fit, and it's fit really well. The next step now is we got all this cardboard here. We're gonna take the cardboard and lay it into the bed. And that's called sheet mulching. So what that does, it helps to prevent the grass from growing up, although the grass probably won't grow up anyways, but definitely a good step to take. The cardboard will just basically compost or biodegrade. The worms will eat it. It'll turn into nothing. Using the more cardboard, the better, especially if you have like invasive grasses like crabgrass. I had to use like 5 layers of cardboard in my community garden. Their grass here, it's not that hardy, so it shouldn't be too much of a problem. And it should be fine. But you know, the more cardboard, the better. So we're gonna get to that next, and we're gonna start wheelbarrowing in all the compost.
All right, so here's the fully lined bed with the hardware cloth, so the gophers can't get in, and this is what it looks like. And that's the whole bed, and we left one side open, so we didn't finish that, because what we're gonna do is we're gonna load up wheelbarrow fulls of the compost, and we'll be doing that in just a few minutes. And we're gonna be just wheelbarrow down through the bed and then just dump it at the end and just keep doing many loads till it's full. All right, so Rick is here doing the sheet mulching. So we're just basically taking cardboard, the thicker cardboard the better, and he has a thin piece there, so he's kind of folded it over on threes, or at least twice over on itself, to make it thicker. That's what he's doing right now. And we've got all this area of the bed basically sheet mulched. So this is sheet mulching. Really simple, really easy, and really effective for keeping down the weeds. In an optimal situation, if you have lots of weeds, you would definitely overlap the cardboard so that there's no space, because what will happen is if there are weeds below here, the weeds will come up in between the cracks. In this situation, there's not a lot of weeds, and there's just this grass. It's not too hardy, so we should be fine. So we're gonna go ahead and finish off sheet mulching.
All right, so now we got all the sheet mulch down. The bed has been basically in this bed now. It's all built. We saw how we sunk the posts in concrete. Rick and Karen put the siding on. Meanwhile, I was cutting the gopher protection, or the hardware cloth fabric we put down, and that's galvanized. And then we put down the cardboard, and you can see the whole bed just has cardboard in it now. And now we're gonna take the shovel and the wheelbarrow and wheelbarrow out some of the 10 cubic yards that has been sitting in Rick and Karen's driveway for, I don't know, maybe about a month now. So let's go get it. All right, so now we're shoveling compost into the wheelbarrow to fill the raised bed. This is a moment Rick's been waiting for his whole life. Well, maybe not his whole life, but a few weeks anyways. He definitely wants to get all this compost out of his driveway. He's been sitting here waiting for the beds to be done.
All right, so here's Rick dumping the first load in the raised beds.
We got the wire down. We got the sheet mulch down. Hallelujah.
All right.
We have compost. Spread it around, and we still have to mix rock dust and some worm casings and other stuff, so I'm not gonna load it up too much, and we'll just keep dumping the load successively back, leave enough room to mix it up and pump it out.
All right, here's why we left the end open, so Rick can come in there with a wheelbarrow, easily go down the bed and dump. We're getting this quickly loaded up. Rick's very fast and efficient. He takes the wheelbarrow and runs back to get the second load, and here I come to help him. Whoa!
So we got the bed basically half or three quarters full of compost. Now we're gonna mix in the rock dust. So the rock dust adds minerals back into the soil, so you have mineral-rich soil, and you will grow mineral-rich foods that will also yield higher and taste better and taste sweeter, actually. My lemon cucumbers taste really, really, really sweet compared to any other lemon cucumbers I tasted. I haven't tasted any better lemon cucumbers, or actually tree kale, or fajoas for that matter. And rock dust really makes your foods taste really good. So Rick and Karen are gonna use rock dust, and they're actually gonna buy more than that, just this bag for this whole raised bed. This is just a start, so we're gonna mix this in and just throw it out. These come in 50 pound bags. All right, we're rock dusted. Ah! All right, so here it is. We've got the bed almost completely full. We planted out the first zucchini plant, and it's getting dark, getting late. Time for dinner time, time to end this work day. Had a great time here at Rick and Karen's today. I'm glad they're finally getting it all done and getting it planted out. And I'm sure next time I come over, I'll see the bed full of awesome vegetables brewing. So this is John Cola with growingyourgreens.com, and keep on growing.